the ability to create a composite model when using a Power BI dataset or an Azure Analysis Services model is in preview since December 2020. However, many of you asked for the ability to do the same when using SQL Server Analysis Services instead of Azure Analysis Services. I'm excited to tell you that with CTP 2 for SQL Server 2022, we will introduce this capability. Once you install that CTP on the server that hosts your Analysis Services model, you can then create a composite model on top. Of course, keep in mind that this is not ready for production workloads, as both the composite model feature related to this and the SQL Server version required have not reached general availability yet. The way this works in Power BI Desktop, however, is very similar to building a composite model using a Power BI dataset or an Azure Analysis Services model. In this scenario, I'm a data analyst at AdventureWorks, and we offer two types of shipment to our users, standard and express. I want to check the average freight cost for each of these types to check everything is in the automated system is working as expected. So in this report, I've marked the orders with express or standard, depending on how our shipping partners said they were handled. And as you can see, about 8,500 orders were handled as express, and the vast majority was handled as standard, which is what I would expect. Now let's get access to the corporate information to see if the freight charges for these match our expectations as well. I'll start by going to get data, and then I choose analysis services. I'll enter the server name that I want to connect to. I'll leave the connection type to direct query because that's what I want to do. Now here I can optionally select which tables I want to connect to. I'll just select all of them and hit submit. So now that we're connected to that enterprise data model, let's take a quick look at the model view and add a relationship between the two data types that I have here. I want to add a relationship between my sales order classification and the sales order, the internet sales order table. So I'll build a relationship on the sales order number. And click OK. Great. So now let's add a scatter plot that will help me do the analysis that I want. So I'll put in margin, the unit price, the freight. I'll change that to the average, and I'll also put in the class for the sales order, which came from my other source. So immediately this jumps out to me that, as expected, notice how the ones that have an average higher freight are all marked as express. Makes sense, you pay more for express. But there's a couple outliers here, and especially here, there's a group of orders that are marked as express, but are, well, on average, lower in freight. So one of the possible explanations could be a promotion. I know we run regular promotions where we might offer free express shipping to our customers. And just to check if that is actually the case here, let me add a quick table to just see the sales order number and the promotion ID. So now if I select a group here, I can see that all of these orders had a promotion ID of 13. And that makes sense, as this promotion, I know, was indeed a free upgrade from standard to express shipping. So now I can easily see that that caused the outlier in chart. As you've seen in this demo, I was able to successfully create a composite model using data from my SQL Server Analysis Services model. Again, as this feature is currently in preview, and the ability to connect to SQL Server Analysis Services requires a CTP version of SQL Server, this is not ready for you to use in production workloads. However, it's an exciting improvement and one we cannot wait to make fully available soon.